Hey there, I hope you're well. My name is Marta, and in this video I will show you how to code the parking lot in Python using classes. In the previous video, I explained how to design a parking lot using object-oriented programming. If you haven't watched that video, I strongly recommend that you check it out just so it's easier for you to follow along. There is a link in the description to the previous video. In this video, I will show you step by step how to implement or code a parking lot in Python using object-oriented programming. Before we start, in case you find this video useful, feel free to subscribe or to follow. This way, you will be notified when I upload more videos about programming. To recap, let's go back to the design from the previous video. This is a design where we have four classes representing the entities of our problem and the relevant data. And in red, the actions each of those classes can perform. The classes are car, parking slot, level, and parking lot. Let's start with the simplest, which is the car. The relevant information that you will need of the car is the license number. The class will have a constructor that will initialize or assign a value to the license number field. Next, I will create the parking slot class. The relevant information of a parking slot is the row where the parking slot is, the position of the spot in the row or the spot number, and the level where the parking slot is. And also, we will save if there is a car occupying the parking slot. I will first create a constructor where I will pass values to all those fields. Now, I will create three extra methods. One method to check if the parking slot is available, another method to park the car in the parking slot, and another method to remove the car from the parking slot. I will advise you to pause the video here and try to add the code for these three methods yourself. Alright, let's start with the isAvailable method. To know if the parking slot is available, I will check if the car field is equal to none. Next, I will write the code for the park method. To do so, you will assign a car to the car field. Next, to remove a car from the parking slot, you will assign none to the car field. This will remove any existing value. Next, I will create the level class and I will create a constructor. The relevant information that you will need of a level is the level number or floor number, the number of rows, and the number of parking slots per row, and a list containing all parking slots that are taken in the level, and another field with the number of spots available in the level. We will calculate this by multiplying the rows and spots per row. Now I will add the methods that will help us to park the car. As we've seen in the design, I will create two methods. One called findAvailableSpot, which will return a free parking slot in the level, and another method to park a car in a free parking slot. Let's start with findAvailableSpot. Something to consider is, in case the level is empty, I will return the first parking slot. If a row is full, it should return the first spot in the next row, and if the level is full, you should return none. I will advise you to pause the video here and try to add the code for this method yourself. Let's see how we can find the next available spot. Please note that there are many ways to solve this problem. This is just one possible solution. First, I will check the available spots, because in case that field is zero, we can just return none, since there is no slots available in this level. In case there are spaces available, I will retrieve the last taken parking slot. Here, you need to consider that the array could be empty. That means all spots are free, so I will return a free parking slot in the first level, first row and first spot. In case there are parking slots occupied, I will get the last one and I will save it in the variable last car park. Now we will check if there are slots available in the row where the last car is, and if so, we will return the spot next to the last car park. If the row is full, we will check that we are not in the last row. If we are not in the last row, it means the next row is empty. So we will return the first free spot in the next row. And that will cover all the cases. And now we will write the code for the next method, which is the park method. This method should return false in case the parking lot is full and you couldn't park the car, and true otherwise. Note that you will need to update the parking slot list and the available spot field. I will advise you to pause the video here and try to add the code for this method yourself. Let's see. First, you will find the free parking slot using the method we created before. If the method returns none, it means there are no spaces available, so I will return false to indicate that I couldn't park the car. Otherwise, it means there are free spots, so I will park the car using the park method I wrote earlier. Then add the parking slot at the end of the list and reduce by one the number of available spots. Cool, we finished writing another class. Now I'm going to show you how you can test your code to make sure your solution is working as you expect. It is possible to have different solutions to this problem. If you test it, you can make sure your solution works. Next, to test my code, I will create a unit test using the unit test library. So I will create a new file, import unit tests, and create a class. You can call it anything. I will call it parking test. And this class will inherit from test case. I haven't explained what inheritance is yet. I will explain this in another video. All you need to know is that you can add a class here between the parentheses and you get access to more functionality. And now I will add a method where I'm going to call the code I just wrote and check if it's returning the values that I expect. For instance, if a level is empty and I try to park a car, the park method should return true, because my code should be able to park the car. If it returns something else, there might be something incorrect in the code. First, I will create a level object. Now we'll park a car in the level. This will return true because there are spaces available. Now, to compare the value that my code returned and the value that I'm expecting, I will use assert equal function. In case this fails, I will get an error that warns me that my code is doing something incorrect. Let's run this and check that the code is actually working. Perfect, let's start writing the last class in our design, the parking lot class. First, I will create a constructor. The important information that I will save of the parking lot is the levels, as we've seen in the design. And I will write now the park method. This method will return true if it has successfully parked the car and false otherwise. You will need to try to park the car in each of the levels. As before, I will advise you to pause the video here so you can try to solve this yourself. Let's see how to write the code. To park the car, I will loop through the levels. If parking the car in the level is successful, then I don't need to try in the next level, so I just return true. If I couldn't park, I will continue and I will try in the next level. And if I couldn't park in any of the levels, I will return false because that means there are no spaces available. And that's all. We reached the end of the video. I really hope you enjoy it. Let me know in the comments if you managed to get the parking lot working. Or let me know if you have any issues, I will be happy to help. In case you enjoyed the video, feel free to subscribe so you will get notified when I upload more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching and happy coding!